Why are you so hopeful, or what are you so hopeful about from this budget?
See, in the budget, the main issue that the world is focusing on the stock markets are focusing on, is whether you will be populist or whether you will try and show that show first and then achieve a reasonable fiscal deficit target. My theory on this has been that the government strategy cannot be that they will get FDI in retail and that is the end of their reform agenda, because that would not achieve anything, whether it is Fitch or S&P. Somebody will downgrade us in the next 6-9 months, our currency will go to 60, and therefore closer to the elections, you would have actually been better off in not even doing that FDI in retail, which in these 9 months will not lead to any inflows or any change in anybody's bottom line. So therefore, my belief is that the government has bought into the idea that reforms are needed even for the Aam Aadmi, because, you know, you earn somewhere and you spend somewhere, or in general that people want delivery and they will not live with this you know, currency and with this amount of fiscal deficit because of high interest rates and everything else that it leads to. Therefore, if it is a one-off issue that they did the 2-3 reforms that they did, or whatever you call them, administrative steps, as being the only tactic that they had, then we would be wrong. But I am hoping that, because, you know, in a sense, Mrs. Gandhi also seems to have bought into it by doing the first pro-reform rally and things like that, that this is slightly bigger agenda than just allowing FDI and retail. And therefore, the budget will be okay in the sense that people will may believe that, yes, some of these pending things are done, that fiscal deficit will be in control. I don't think beyond a point, other than this environment ministry, you know, some I read somewhere today, and I think ET or somewhere, that another ministry wants to take them to court. These kind of things should be resolved. And if that needs, not reforms, that just needs somebody to show the ministers their place, and, you know, so those things should be done. It is that which is not happening, I would say. From a budget point of view, if you say fiscal deficit target seems reasonable and you haven't done any new outright giveaways, people will accept it and market will move on. Market is not overly needing government except in these infrastructure-related decision-making. And those things are not really reforms.
But despite that,
administrative steps which are not being taken.
Right. But despite that, you're saying you are more bullish today than you were even 3 months ago.
Yeah, you see, that is because I am assuming that this is now part of a package, in the sense that when government, when the budget shows that the deficit is a little bit in control, that the Reserve Bank of India becomes a little bit, you know, dovish in some sense, cuts interest rates, and therefore becomes a package. And the third is that in general, the world has, you know, moved along. Right now, the if you look at the other indices, that is in Brazil, China, and whatever, the BRIC countries, Russia. The last month, India is up some 1%, and these guys are all up 8 to 10%. China is up some 15%. So, in some sense, the issues that we were outperforming and the rest of the world either had to go up or we had to correct, plus the fact that the U.S. fiscal cliff problem has not been solved but has been averted, I think is a bigger positive than if it had been solved comprehensively. If the U.S. were to really do a grand deal, a deal in which they cut spending and increase taxes, and the mix is such that their fiscal path is very good, we would look even worse to the world that a U.S. which has $1 trillion a year deficit can solve it, and we can't solve one small problem. We can't sell our existing assets. They have gone and done an AIG, bailed it out and resold it, and now AIG is filing a case against the government for having bailed them out in the first place. So we don't want the rest of the world to look overly smart also. We want them to look smart enough so that they are not in a crisis. In that sense, the Indian government is not any different from what happened in the US. So in some sense, on a relative basis, they are not that bad anymore, I would think. We'll be right back.